Blessed be, and welcome to the Circle of Heka. I'm Lady Maris. Okay, so you've done a little bit of work. You've tried out a few spells, maybe. You've thought, okay, this witchcraft thing, I think it's for me. Now, do I tell anyone? Do I need to tell anyone? Well, let's see if we can break it down a little bit and work out, you know, whether it needs to or not. As I've said before, your spiritual practice is something that is your own. It is that essence of you, and it's a lot of the times a very private thing. So not everyone thinks and believes that everyone should know what it is that they do. And that's fine. And others just want to shout it from the rooftops. And again, that's fine. Whatever works for you. But you need to, again, work out why do you want to tell anyone? And what purpose is it going to serve? Now, let's break it down to if you are under 18 and you live at home. You will then, I would say, as a courtesy and respect to your parents, let them know that this is the path that you have chosen to follow. There will be questions, and you'd have to be able to understand your path enough to answer those questions in a clear way, so that the person asking those questions gets a sense that you know what it is that you are talking about, that you understand what it is that you're entering into, and that you've got a clear concept. It's not just going and someone asking you, oh, so why, you know, what's it about? And you go, oh, well, you know, my friend Jenny, she's doing it, and it looks like a bit of fun. That's not really going to fly. You need to have a clear understanding and a reasoning why you've decided to follow a different spiritual path than the one that maybe under the roof that you live in. But I still believe that you need to let your parents know, because one, they are probably a lot smarter than you give them credit for, and they probably already have an inkling that there is something that you are pursuing. Two, if you have little bits and pieces like incense and candles and other stuff in your room that you are burning and using, you don't want them to think that you're using that to hide the fact that you're taking drugs. You know, you're burning incense to hide the weed smell or whatever it is. So you need to obviously let them know, and it shows that you are becoming an adult. You are thinking about certain things. And you also need to understand and respect that they may not say yes, or they may not condone you doing certain practices under their house, under their roof. So you have to be mindful and understand that that could be not under my roof policy. Which is fine. Remember, you are young and you have the rest of your life to pursue the goddess and god, or to pursue witchcraft, to pursue magic. You have the rest of your life, a few more years, for you to take a step back, do a bit more study, a bit more research, maybe a little bit more introspection before you start to really kind of go full pelt with this path. Is a good thing, because as you are young, and I don't want to make it sound like I'm being disrespectful to yourselves, but just going from my own experience, that when I was young, I was experimenting with lots of different things. One week, well, it wasn't necessarily a week, but 1 month, say, I was experimenting with the goth kind of look. Another time, I was experimenting with some other kind of a fashion kind of look or some kind of ideal, and it was about me finding myself and finding what works for me and experimenting and working out where I fit in. And at this stage, witchcraft or Wicca may be it, but it may not be it for the rest of your life. And that's something that you need to work out. So taking that time, if your parents do say, not under my house, is a good thing. It also means that you become more resourceful. You don't have to become sneaky, but if there is a thing where, well, no burning candles, no spells or whatever under my roof, then you go out into nature. You find a park, you find a place, a wild place if you're able to do that. And you sit and you commune with nature, you commune with the goddess, and you can do your spells and you can do your magic and not have to worry that your parents are going to come in. So you learn to be resourceful, you learn to work things out, bend and shape. Witches are benders and shapers of reality, so you need to learn how to become resourceful in that respect. But have respect for your parents and let them know. And if they do say no, it's not the end of the world. You just need to do a little bit more introspection, meditate a little bit more, do all of those sorts of things that you need to do to follow witchcraft, all of those foundational bits and pieces that you need to do that may not necessarily be overtly witchy on the outside, but will help you in leaps and bounds when you are able to outwardly study your craft. So, parents, okay, if you have a significant other, do you tell them? Now, I would hope that your significant other, your husband or your fiance or long-term boyfriend or girlfriend or whatever it is that your partner would have at least an inkling as to what person you are and what you're pursuing and what your feelings and hopes and dreams are, so they would have at least an idea of what it is that you are looking into and pursuing. So when you tell them, look, this is actually for me and I want to pursue it openly, then they should have already know this. They should have some kind of idea. It shouldn't be just like, oh my God, where did this come out of? Something out of left field. Unless they are totally clueless. But I would hope and expect that anyone who is studying some kind of form of spirituality or has some kind of form of spirituality wouldn't be with someone who has zero spirituality whatsoever. So it wouldn't be so much of a shock. Now, if you are single and you're looking for a significant other, do you broach the subject, or when do you broach that subject? Again, it's something that you do for different people at different times. And some people will say something straight up and others will wait until they think that person is someone that they want to bring into their lives a little bit more. So you maybe need to remember that when you are dating, some of these people you'll have maybe one or two dates with and realize they're just not for you. And that's fine. That's what dating's all about. But again, depending on who it is that you're talking to, slamming down the witch bomb can be quite confronting to people, and they may not take the information the way that you would like them straight away, especially if they don't really know you and know how you work. So again, I can't say on this date you will tell them this and on this date you will tell them this. It's not how it works. It's a flowing thing, and Yes, is there going to be some anxiety involved when you tell anybody something about yourself that is that gets close to the core of you? That's the way things go. And when you are looking for a significant other, looking for a mate, a life partner, whatever it is that you want to call it, there is that slowly stripping away the layers that is you, so that they become more and more aware of the core that is you, not the nice person that you are portraying when you first meet. You know, everyone's on their best behavior. They start to get to know you a little bit more, and at some stage you will feel comfortable enough to let them into that part of your life, and they would have gotten to know you in and slowly different facets of you without having that witch bomb put on there, or that signpost that says witch, which then puts you into a box that is the witch box. And that box is whatever that person who has put you in that box believes a witch is. Okay, so most of that time it will be media propaganda, and whatever, if they happen to have raised in some kind of religion, whatever religious propaganda that was. Not necessarily what you are, but now you have, by the specific use of that word straight away, put yourself in their box as to what you are. And that's not something that you really want to do. I don't think so anyway. So it's up to you when it comes to the right time to tell someone that part of yourself. Do you tell your employer? I personally don't think your employer needs to know. That is what you do in your own time, is your own time. Unless what you're doing in your own time is something that is inhibiting someone's free will, or endangering someone, or physically hurting or mentally hurting someone, then maybe your employer should probably know, and maybe the police and a few other people should know. But if you are doing whatever it is, like your employer doesn't need to know that you play tennis on the weekends, and say your employer doesn't necessarily need to know that one night a week you watch ridiculous rom-coms or whatever it is. They don't need to know those sorts of things, that you do in your own home in your own time. So whether you're a witch or not is something that they don't necessarily need to know. And you also have to think, what is going to be gained by yourself by telling your employer or telling people that you work with? If it's information that just comes out, then that's a different thing. But if you actively go around and go, haha, I'm a witch, well, don't mess with me because I'm a witch, then you have to look at your motives, your reasonings behind that. What do you seek to gain by giving that information over? Because most of the time, giving that information over to an employer or to people that you work with is not going to help your work situation. It's probably going to hinder that work situation, because now your work colleagues are going to go, oh, well, either that person's completely insane, or they're full of themselves, or, well, we can't talk to that person because they're going to put a spell on us, or they're going to think they're going to put a spell on us because they're, woo-hoo. All of that sort of thing is not going to be working for you. It's going to be working against you. If it's just something that's organic that comes out, and they kind of know you already, and you don't make a really big thing about it, then a lot of the times people are just go, oh yeah, that's fine, just witchy, whatever, that's fine. But if you make a big thing about it, then people are going to start to go, oh, okay, what, you're taking yourself a little bit too seriously. And start to get a little bit worried, and maybe feel a little bit intimidated, or fearful, or worried that you've lost it. So think about what it is that you feel that you are going to gain by telling your employer, because ultimately your employer doesn't need to know. With all of this, do I tell? It is need to know basis. There are many facets of your life that you do not tell every single person, okay? It is a need to know. So whether you're a witch or not is a need to know. So I'll use myself as an example for a few things. I don't, when I meet new people, I don't introduce myself as Lady Amaris. I don't tell, in the pagan community, I don't introduce myself as Lady Amaris. I will probably introduce myself as Amaris, but that will be the extent of that. I don't tell anyone that I'm a witch in, say, mundane areas. That's not the first thing. You know, oh, hi, pleased to meet you. Oh, yeah, by the way, I'm a witch. Not what I do. I'll rarely wear a pentacle. I'll do, on odd occasions when the outfit warrants it and whether I can be bothered and feel like it. But it's not something that I wear out there so people will have a look. It's not my badge or my shield or whatever it is. So it's not something that people know about me straight away. It may be something that people will understand and divine later on about me, but it's not something that it's like, hey, here you go. I've never met a Christian or a Buddhist or a Muslim person that introduces themselves and says, hi, you know, I'm Gary and I'm Jewish. You know, don't do that. So doing that as a witch just seems a little bit weird to me. But again, each to their own. If it's something that's asked, if someone asks me, then yeah, I'll say, well, yeah, I do this, or yes, I am, or whatever the case may be. But I won't, again, make a great big song and dance about it, because it doesn't require a big song and dance. It's a facet of me. It's a part of me. It's not the entirety of me. Because again, as I said, you get put into a box a lot of the times. And it's not just the witch box. You get put into the, oh, I'm a secretary box. I'm a mother box. I am a I'm a doctor box. I'm a policeman box. All of those little boxes that people like to put in, little categories that people like to put in. It's not the entirety of me. I am a witch, yes, but I am many, many other things as well as a witch. So putting me into that little box is me just saying and introducing myself as, yeah, I'm a witch, limits me, because I am many, many things. I'm a witch, I'm a magical practitioner, I am a friend, I am a lover, all of those things that make up who I am, not just this one little part of me. It is a large part of me, but it's not the only part of me. So saying something to someone or not saying something to someone is ultimately your decision. But please, like anything, think it through. Work out what it is that you want to achieve from that. If you are telling people just so that people will be frightened of you, that people will look at you and respect you more, that people will just be fearful of you, then you may miss the point of what witchcraft is all about. Telling someone that you are a witch just so that they'll be frightened of you means that you don't have that power to begin with, and that is something you need to cultivate. You don't need to tell anyone that you are powerful. That should be something that's self-evident. So think about what it is that you want to achieve by telling people. If you are a minor under 18 in your parents' house, common courtesy and respect to let them know they are your parents. They want to see the best for you. They want to protect you and guide you and help you. They don't want to see you going down any kind of path that may be harmful. So let them know, help them to understand by knowing your craft. Yeah, I hope that makes sense. I hope I didn't go off and ramble too much. With anything in the craft, it's up to you. It's your decision. It's your road that you travel. How fast or how slow is up to you. And who knows and who doesn't, again, is up to you. Merry meet, merry part, and merry meet again. Blessed be. Have to...